Well, hello there, and welcome to another online worship opportunity with the community of faith of Alamance Lutheran Church. Hi, I'm Pastor Ron Philibon. Today's festival is a bridge between the Advent, Christmas, Epiphany cycle that comes to a close today, and the Lent Easter cycle that begins in several days. Now, on a high mountain, Jesus is revealed as God's beloved Son, echoing the words at his baptism. This vision of glory sustains us as Jesus faces his impending death in Jerusalem. We turn this week to Ash Wednesday and our yearly baptismal journey from Lent to Easter. Some churches put aside the Alleluia at the conclusion of today's liturgy. This word of joy will be omitted during this penitential season of Lent and will be sung again at Easter. So come along with us today as we learn and we grow together. Come on, Jax. With Epiphany behind us and Lent ahead of us, let us quiet ourselves as we prepare to be inspired by the Holy Spirit with this message. Please pray with me. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, Yahweh, my rock and my redeemer. Amen. Well, a few weeks ago when we were studying the Sermon on the Mount, I shared with you how often we find in Scripture when some revelation is about to be given, it occurs on a mountain. And today's texts are no exception. In our first reading, Moses climbs Mount Sinai and gives instruction to listen to Aaron and Ur while he is on the mountain with God. And in our gospel message in Matthew, we hear much of the same imagery when Jesus, Peter, James, and John have reached the top of the mountain where Jesus is transfigured. These disciples who were singled out to accompany Jesus knew something important was going to be revealed on that mountain. They just didn't know what. A day in the life with Jesus must have been pretty amazing for them. For example, they witnessed Jesus multiply scraps of food to be enough to transform the lives of thousands of people who were listening to him. They experienced the wind and the waves transformed into a quiet, placid sea. In addition, the countless number of people's lives who were transformed through healing of their health and their hearts. But this time, they were about to experience something that only John the Baptist and his disciples and the people at the Jordan had witnessed at Jesus' baptism. A revelation from God's own voice. This is my Son. God is confirming who Jesus is. And in case you may have been wondering, now what? Right here, God not only says in a loud, clear voice who Jesus is, but a command that we today need to take notice of. Listen to him. Listen. With every human authority we have ever experienced, whether it's a parent, a teacher, a supervisor, each have expected us to do what? You have any ideas? Well, I imagine they expected us to listen. God is very clear in his audible voice to Peter to listen to Jesus. Although Peter, James, and John fell flat in fear, Jesus touched them and said, "Get up and do not be afraid." Have you been struck with fear when you felt the Holy Spirit nudge you to share Christ's message with another person? Well, as we get older, our youthful enthusiasm and innocence tends to become more reserved. Yet, there are times when we get so excited about something that we just have to tell somebody. And I'm sure many of you have overheard people talking too loud on the phone because they were excited or while they were waiting at the doctor's office. Well, there's a story about a young man who pops into the Department of Motor Vehicles to renew his driver's license. He sits down beside this older couple and was clean cut, casually dressed. He was even wearing a backwards baseball cap that said, "I heart Jesus." He immediately strikes up a conversation with this older couple, and the volume in which he spoke was so loud that he was, well, a little annoying. He began by telling this couple that he got saved this year. He said, "On January 13th, the Lord got my attention," he said several times. He began to share his experience as he spoke. He told them how his family could not believe that he was going to church now. He told the couple about all the new things he was learning as he read in his Bible. "Well, I read the NIV because it's written on a level that I can understand since I don't read so good," he said. "I can only read like a sixth grader. And I'm sorry if I'm speaking too loud. I don't hear too good. I have one of those things in my ear to help me hear. I love what it says on the back of my car. Christians aren't perfect, just forgiven. That's what I am. I'm forgiven." Well, he continued moving in rapid fire from one topic to another, but each topic always reverted to his newfound faith experience. "See, I was saved on January 13th. The persistent drone of stories began to eat away at the peace in the room. And maybe you have been in a room like that and grew weary of the childlike explanations of deep theological issues. Maybe you also grew tired of the loud tones and sharp voices from people like his. It may have seemed as though, like him, they were, well, too excited, too eager, too saccharine sweet in their story, maybe even too unbelievable. Or what if we realized in those circumstances that, like this excited young man who was so changed by the transforming presence of Christ in his life on January 13th, that he could do nothing but tell others of his story? What if all of us were so excited, so changed, so childlike in our exuberance that we were not able to stop telling the stories?" That young man in his simple and loud voice was like Peter, telling others about his own transfiguration. He was the voice of the transformed. He was the oddity in the midst of the familiar, and his voice was the unusual in the noise of life. He was a most remarkable man. You've heard some news this morning, haven't you, that is most remarkable in our gospel. And I hope you have heard the Holy Spirit speaking to your heart, which will give you the enthusiasm of Peter and James and John and, yes, even the young man at the DMV. Every day when you wake, I pray that you ask God to speak to you in such a way that opens your heart to share Jesus with someone else. Just like he's speaking to you right now. So now, may the Lord bless and protect you. May the Lord's face radiate with joy because of you. And may he be gracious to you, show you his favor, and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.